Midway through the 22nd century, robots developed and maintained by the USS Corporation suddenly turned against humanity. They flooded the water supply with harmful nanites, sending most of the population into a coma-like state. These countless men, women, and children were loaded into transport shuttles and whisked away. No one knows where. No one knows why. More than a year has passed since the incident. Those who managed to evade the robots' clutches scavenge the now silent cities. Mechanized police and drones search relentlessly for any remaining signs of life. Even most domestic bots now report humans on sight. Under USS Corp's watchful eye, a new robotic civilization is emerging from the ashes of the old. In the face of encroaching extinction, the few who remain fight to survive, searching for the reason behind humanity's fate and clinging to the hope of better days ahead.
There's no time, Em. Saw some cops down the block. Probably the neighborhood patrol. Have you got the list?
No, but we know what we need. Vera was up all night. If we don't find something to break the fever, sooner or later, someone's gonna hear her crying. That's priority number one.
Brian still isn't sleeping, and Alex's leg is making him even crankier than normal. We should find something for them, too.
Definitely. We'll cover more ground if we split up. Let me know what you find.
You got it.
Surprised the robots haven't been here yet. They scavenge all sorts of scrap. God knows why. Whoa, that's a lot of drugs. I don't know what they're all for, but I gotta find something for Vera's fever. And I'm guessing it's in that case. I hate to admit it, but if Matt were here, he'd figure something out. Well, that's a little inconvenient. This shelf's cutting off access to all the pediatric medicines. We have to find a way to move it without drawing any attention. Definitely not moving it on my own. Park, give me a hand over here.
Sure thing.
cops will hear it. Need to find another way. Ideas?
This thing's way too heavy for us to lift on our own. We might have better luck if we had some kind of a lever.
Let's take a look. Could be some tools I can use. Every time Park's asthma kicks in, I feel so helpless. It's some cable. Damn it, just my luck. Hey, I found this. Thought it might be, you know, useful.
Great. I've been scared to check, but I think the one I've been using is on its last legs.
So, what have we got here? Nice room. It's alive. Nice work, Emily. What's left of humanity is a little bit like this poor little guy. No one left to water it. Oh, the irony. So comfy. A safe. Now, how to go about getting it open? Maybe Brian could hack the safe, but I'm not getting it open without a key. There's a lot of things I missed from before, but the idiot box isn't one of them. I don't think I'll find medical supplies in there. Nope, not the time, Emily. So, what have we got here? Painkillers. Bingo. These will come in handy for sure. Whoa, that thing's massive. If only it was full of food. Surprise, out of order. Right, no power. Talk about one-stop shopping. There's batteries all over the place. This arrow car looks like it's been sitting here for a while, probably since before the incident. I'd better check for anything useful. Damn it, it's locked. But I'm guessing the key can't be too far. The back door is already unlocked. Could be useful if we need to cut and run. We're not finished here. This isn't just any old supply run. We have to find something for Vera's fever. I'm positive that the meds we need are buried under this shelf, but how am I gonna move it? This thing weighs a ton.
Maybe. If this thing comes crashing down, you'll hear the noise for blocks.
Gotta come up with something. Maybe Brian could hack the safe, but I'm not getting it open without a key. Nope, not the time, Emily. Finders keepers? Surprise, out of order. This thing's been lying here for a long time. I can use this to turn on the fridge, but first I have to get the power up and running. Marta would love this. She's crazy about anime and pretty much anything else from Japan. Grandpa used a wheelchair too. He refused to have anything to do with mechanized prosthetics. He said all this newfangled technology couldn't be trusted. He hit that nail on the head.
Finding this drugstore was a godsend. Luckily, it has some more of the meds Justin needs. Although, let's be honest, a wheelchair is already pretty much a death sentence in this city. Thankfully, this place is the perfect place to hole up. Might even stay a while. Food could become a problem, since the closest store is 3 blocks away, but Justin's safety has to come first. I've been going from time to time to scout out the area, praying they don't spot me. Turns out the commotion I heard yesterday was a group of people trying to hide here. Nothing but former survivors now. You know what? Everything worked out. They made a bunch of racket in the sales area, but I just shut the door and they never even knew we were here.
Thank you.
We're not finished here. This isn't just any old supply run. We have to find something for Vera's fever. Still quiet so far, but we have to hurry. Maybe the music helps him keep the bad thoughts at bay. Whatever it is, he's changed. He's friendly. Positive. No, it's not gonna work. There has to be another way. Think! A kid's toothbrush. It's so tiny and cute. Damn it, it's locked. But I'm guessing the key can't be too far. No good. Out of reach. Surprise! Out of order. Nope, not the time, Emily. 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 I'll have a look on my way out of here. Yuck. It smells like something died in here. Makes sense. Robots don't have much need for plumbing.